Hello, and welcome to Lesson 2 of Lean Communication. In Lesson 1, we saw that communication is the most important professional skill that we deploy in our work. We also saw that there's a ton of room for improvement and that the solution is lean communication. In this lesson, we're going to take it a step further. We're going to dig deeper into the key insight that makes lean thinking so powerful when it's applied to communication. And my goal for this lesson is that you will embrace the mindset and practices of lean communication. The mindset, hopefully immediately, the practices, of course, are going to take time. So what is lean communication? Lean communication is based on an insight that came to me about 8 or 10 years ago. And I got the insight because I had received a call from the CEO of a manufacturing company who had heard about the work that I had done with a former client and had asked if I could come in and teach his executives to become more effective and more efficient communicators when they were communicating with him. So I always like to put things in terms that my listeners understand. And I started thinking, how is a manufacturing company going to respond to my message? And the insight hit me that producing a message that a listener values is extremely similar to producing a product that a customer values. You take in inputs, you apply work to them, except in this case, the factory is called your brain, to produce a message that a listener values. Once I had that insight, I started seeing a lot of similarities between lean thinking and communication. I've applied them to this, and I think that you'll see that there is a ton of value in the approach that we're going to take. So what exactly is lean communication? Lean communication is all about producing more value with less waste. Just like in a product, you want to produce a better product at a lower cost, in lean communication, you want to produce a better message at a lower cost to the listener. So let's take each one of those one by one. First of all, what is value? Value, as you can see here, is useful communication that improves business and or personal outcomes while preserving the relationships. In other words, you leave people better off and they're happier as a result. And we're going to dig into value a lot more in the next lesson. But keep this definition in mind as we go. So then the next question is, well, what is waste? Well, waste is pretty simple. Any work or input that does not directly contribute to value. And we see waste all over the place. In manufacturing, you have waste such as defects, such as waiting time, such as moving things around, etc. In communication, you have sometimes too much information. Sometimes you have not enough information. Sometimes you have incomplete information. Sometimes there are errors in the information. There may be misunderstandings. There may be hurt feelings as a result of the communication. So we see waste everywhere we go. So what we want to do is improve value and take out waste. And if we want to measure it, one of the best ways to measure it is to improve the ROTE. Instead of ROI, which is return on investment, we want to improve the listener's return on time and effort. In other words, give them more value, take a lot less of their time in giving them that value, and make it as simple and clear as possible so that they can understand it without putting in a lot of mental effort. Once we look at it this way, then we start deploying some of the elements of lean to communication. Five elements of lean, as you can see on this slide right here. We start, number one, with value. Value is the starting point, and value is the ending point. You need to produce something that a listener values. Otherwise, it doesn't matter how little time or effort that they put into understanding the message. So we start with value. Then we organize our message in a way that makes it clear to them what's going to be coming next. We cut out waste as much as possible. We make work visible. In other words, we make the workflow visible to ourselves and to the listener. This makes it a lot easier to understand our logic and to follow our meaning. And then finally, we use the pull system, because we may do the first four things really well and still get it wrong because we can never fully understand what the listener is thinking. So we let the listener dictate the pace at which they absorb the message. So you take these five elements, and this turns into 10 keys to lean communication. In value, the first two keys are outside-in thinking and clear purpose. This is about getting into your listener's head to understand what they value and then having a clear purpose, in other words, understanding the value that you get from the communication as well. The organization that we're going to do is primarily from the top down. We give the message up front and then we build the pyramid from the top down, and that will make more sense as we get into that lesson. Then, to reduce waste, we ruthlessly apply this thing that I call the so what filter. What information do they actually need that is integral or important, and filter out the merely interesting or the irrelevant. Then we make work visible. And there are three keys to make work visible. One is transparent structure, the next one is being candid and direct, and the third is user-friendly language. Finally, we have three keys to make the pull system work. The first one is the pull principle itself, letting the listener dictate what information they need, when they need it, in order to make maximum use of the message that they're getting. That requires two skills. One is the ability to ask questions, because so far everything we've been talking about is about transmitting a message, but we need to make sure that message is being received, or we can even use questions to get them to tell us what we want them to hear. Don't worry, that'll make more sense as when we get to that lesson. And finally, and we probably should have started with this in some cases, but we also have to, besides being very good message producers, we need to apply lean listening to make sure that we are understanding what the listener values, what the listener needs from us, and so on. So these are the 10 elements of lean communication, and we will take those each in their own separate lessons. And if we can make it even more simple, let's think about A, B, C, D. The A is for add value, that's the first section. The next section is B, brevity. The next section is C, clarity, and then finally D, dialogue. Now, I would be remiss if I didn't end with a little bit of caveats and limits. I'm not the first one to tell you that lean communication is something that you do all the time. In fact, if you did lean communication all the time, you could probably get yourself in trouble. There's a few things to think about. First of all, don't try this at home. Now, I say that kind of tongue in cheek, but the point is that a lot of times when relationships are the more important part of the discussion, we can't be ruthlessly efficient in producing our message. We need to be a lot more wordy. We need to produce a lot more what you might consider waste in terms of getting the message across, but are very important for the relationships. There are times that you don't want to get straight to the point. There are times you want people to talk, you want to draw people out, you need a lot of brainstorming and creativity. And in that case, you certainly don't want to be very careful about parsing your words on that. And then finally, there are cultural considerations. I'm coming from a Western culture, which tends to be much more direct than some other cultures, and I fully understand that there are differences. That's a little bit outside the scope of this course, but it is something to keep in mind and to recognize as you go. Once you start learning the principles of lean communication, you'll be able to apply your own judgment as to when to use it and when not to use it.